I just want to say I'm very pleased to be a longtime member of the Senate Education Committee and also once again to be a member of this Conference Committee on Education as we put together our next year's state budget. And I appreciate the leadership of Senator Marcelino in these endeavors. In my area of the state, our schools, and I'm sure this is true in all areas of the state for that matter, our public schools are truly the center of the community, as well as our libraries serve the same same role as well. And that is why this conference committee and the work that we do to put together, you know, the state aid package for education is critically important, certainly to the students, faculty, and staff of our various schools, but also to the community as a whole. That's how I have always viewed it and continue to feel that way. And as I talk with my local school officials and others associated with our local schools, they are asking us for assistance when it comes to some key areas. Certainly, you know, the state aid package, and they're asking for the flexible dollars that foundation aid provides, and I'm very, very pleased that our Senate version of the budget calls for a bump up in foundation aid for the next year. Also, they're asking along the lines of flexible spending and funding. Our package provides flexibility for the community schools funding so that our local school leaders can, in fact, decide the best way to spend those dollars to truly benefit the community through the schools. Very pleased that we fully fund the expense-driven aids once again this year, and at the same time, reject the governor's proposal to cap going forward those expense-driven aids. So very, very important. Our schools are also asking for more mental health services in the schools, and our package provides funding for additional mental health services in our public schools, which is critically important to all. When it comes to libraries, once again, centers of our community, and I'm very, very pleased that our Senate budget not only restores the governor's $4 million cut for our libraries, but actually would increase aid to our libraries to the tune of $2 million in additional funding for our public libraries. And once again, not only restoring the governor's cut for capital funding for our libraries, but actually would increase that as well. So many, many issues associated with the education package for this year, and I'm very pleased to be part of this conference committee to delve into these issues and develop a good, sound package to benefit our schools and students and faculties and also our communities and local taxpayers. Thank you.